The jar of Nutella is reflecting light rays from the light source in your room. Some rays of light will reflect off from the Nutella jar, to the mirror, and then into your eyes. The law of reflection says that the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection, but this still doesn't explain how the jar's image appears inside of the mirror when the piece of paper is clearly blocking it. The virtual image of the jar can be found using this optics technique that I'm about to show you. You extend the path of the reflected ray behind the mirror like this. Repeat this step using a second reflected ray, extending it to the back of the mirror. Notice how I'm using a dotted line here when extending the line through to the back of the mirror. And that's because the light rays don't physically travel through to the other side of the mirror in this direction. Where the two rays intersect, that is the location that our eyes perceive the object's virtual image to be. But why do we call it a virtual image? A virtual image is produced if the reflected rays don't actually converge. This is why virtual images cannot be projected onto a screen. And there's one more interesting physics fact about virtual images inside a mirror. If I place the object 5 centimeters from the mirror, the virtual image will also appear 5 centimeters away from the mirror. The image and the objects are the same distance from the mirror.